Assalamu alaikum, dear colleagues and friends. Most of the time, you know, in interviews for mathematics lecturership, these questions are asked. For example, we are in MCQ number 107. What is a perfect number? What is a perfect number? So, the answer for this question is any integer which, when doubled, equals to sum of its positive divisors. Now, what does it mean? Let us see the example. For example, n is equal to 6 is a perfect number. N is equal to 6 is a perfect number because its positive divisors are 1, 2, 3 and 6. Now, when we sum up these positive divisors, it becomes 12. Of course, these are the positive divisors of 6. When we add them, we get 12. And 12 is, of course, 2 times of 6. So 6 is perfect number because when 6 is doubled, it equals to the sum of its positive divisors. So such integer is called perfect number. I have another example for you people. Similarly, n is equal to 28 is a perfect number. Why? Because its positive divisors are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 20. These are the positive divisors of 28. Now, when we add all of these positive divisors, we get 56, and 56 is of course double of 28. So it means that when 28 is doubled, it equals to the sum of its positive divisors. So such number is called perfect number. MCQ number 108, like this question can be asked in interview. Suppose we have been given a data like inputs and outputs. Like suppose inputs we have numbers, and outputs we have, like function is given in a form of a table of values. How can we obtain the formula from this table of values, like the formulaic version of this function? And it is pronounced as, how shall we can fit equation for this data? Do you know any method when a function is given in the form of a table of values? So the answer is that we can use many methods, but few are least square method. And least square, this method is from the statistics. And Newton-Gregory method, it is basically from numerical analysis. There are many methods, Lagrange method, and there are many other methods. But least square method and Newton-Gregory method can be used to fit equation for this data. Okay, here we are in 109 number MCQs. Although it is statistical, but I want to mention it for your knowledge because it may be asked. For binomial distribution, suppose if we have binomial distribution, okay, then variance is always less than the expectation, I mean the mean. And this is the reason here you can see what is the proof of that. Because we know in binomial distribution, NPQ is the formula for variance and NP is the formula for the mean, I mean the expectation. And from here, cancellation will lead, and this is Q, and Q is always less than 1. So it means that variance is always less than the mean. Number 110 number MCQs, it is also statistical, but I want to mention it for your knowledge. It may be asked in interviews. For binomial distribution, is it possible that variance is 4 and expectation is 2? Is it possible? So the answer is no, because for binomial distribution, variance is always less than the expectation. So variance can not be greater than the mean. So it is not true. Okay. 111, this is also statistical. Let us see quickly to which distribution we give preference. Number one, this is multiple choice. To which distribution we give preference? Number one, distribution which has this number of parameters, distribution which has many parameters. So the answer is, of course, distribution having less number of parameters. It is preferred. Okay. Bernoulli distribution. Bernoulli distribution, it is also statistical, but I want to go quickly through it and want to increase your knowledge as well. It may be asked in interviews. Bernoulli distribution is a special case of binomial distribution. Okay, in binomial distribution, we have n is equal to 1. 113 number MCQ, what it is saying? It is saying that the linear differential equation of the form, of course, this is called Bernoulli differential equation, which is named after Bernoulli. Here it is actually, this is the, you know, from here we can identify, here we have y power n. So it is actually Bernoulli differential equation. 114, It is also a statistical distribution answer, a distribution whose probability density function look like 1 over n, constant 1 over n, where n is the total number of observations and 0 otherwise. So such type of discrete distribution is called discrete uniform distribution. Okay. This is also statistical, but we need to discuss it as well, because it may be asked in interview. What is discrete uniform random variable? A random variable X having a discrete function given, suppose you have a random variable whose probability density function of this form, then such type of random variable is called discrete uniform random variable. Okay. This is also statistical but important. The unknown quantity involved in the density function is called parameter. Like you normal distribution, you can see the unknown quantity in the density functions is called the parameter. Okay, we know kurtosis is also statistical. Kurtosis is actually a measure which measures the nearness to the mean. The more the values near to the mean, less will be the variability. Kurtosis is a sort of measure which tell you the nearness to the mean of the data. Okay, this is also statistical, but we need to discuss it. Laplace probability density function, this is actually the probability density function of the Laplace distribution. 119, if you see, relationship between arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. We have two important relations. We know that square of the geometric mean is equal to product of the arithmetic mean and harmonic mean, which can also be written in this ratio form. Ratio of A to the arithmetic mean to the geometric mean is equal to ratio of the geometric mean to the harmonic. Simply rearrangement of this will give you this. And the second relation which we have, arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean is greater than harmonic mean if the two real numbers, if the two real numbers are actually distinct positive. And in that case, geometric mean is equal to square root of AB. Third one is that arithmetic mean will be less than the geometric mean will be less than harmonic mean if the both of the numbers are distinct and negative, and in that case you will having the formula for the geometric mean is this. Okay, 120 number MCQ is important, but we will just Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum dear viewers, colleagues. Today we have very beautiful question or MCQ. It can be asked in interview or it may come in the question paper for jobs, etc. of mathematics lecturership or other teaching mathematical job. 120 number MCQs are question. It is saying that prove that minus minus is equal to plus. Now how to prove that? That is minus A into minus B is equal to positive AB. In other words, it means like this. Now how to prove this quickly? Now if you see that, my dear friends and colleagues, here we need to prove that these two quantities are actually basically equal. Now what is the strategy? We know that the additive inverse of AB is minus AB. We know that this is the additive inverse of AB. And we know that the additive inverse is unique. If this quantity is also additive inverse of this, it means that these two are equal. So this is the strategy we will be using. So let us add this thing and this quantity. If it becomes zero, it means that this is the additive inverse of this, and hence these two are equal. So let us add them together. And it will be the ultimate proof of minus into minus is equal to plus, basically. Okay, so you can repeat my words if somebody is beginner, very very beginner, then okay. So if you see that we actually add these two quantities, now we can write this minus inside like here, and we have plus. Now taking minus A common, here you see this is common, so we have minus B plus B, so of course 0, and we know that any number multiplied by 0 is 0. So we get what does it mean? It means that this quantity is the additive inverse of this quantity, but this is also additive inverse of this quantity as well, but we know that additive inverse is unique. So it means that this quantity and this quantity are the same because they have the same additive inverse. And this is the strategy which used to prove this this beautiful fact, minus minus is equal to plus. Okay, another beautiful question which can be asked in interview is that what are the fundamental theorems of mathematics, there are many fundamental theorems. Three here we will mention. Three of them are fundamental theorem of algebra, fundamental theorem of calculus, also called fundamental theorem of integral, both are okay, integral calculus, and